Hi, everyone. We've got another question from a fellow boater. This question asks basically the following. Jeff, my boat has a start battery, a house battery. All right, good. And a battery switch on and off. Now, that's where it gets a little bit confusing. Two battery sources and only one battery switch. Generally, when you're going to have two battery sources, you're going to need to have either two battery switches or three. Two on-off battery switches at least, and or a combined switch. So that would be the third switch. Or you'll have what's called a source selector battery switch, which allows you to decide what runs what. Does battery one run your boat? Does battery two run your boat? Or do you have all batteries running your boat? I've talked about this at length. I know it sounds a little bit boring, but there is a little bit of nuance in terms of battery switching, and that does affect the reliability of our electrical systems on board. So the boater goes on and asks, Jeff, if I'm running my boat on the starter battery, how would my depth sounder or fish finder work if it was hooked on to the house battery? The way to do that would be to have a battery switch that basically has effectively almost three switches inside. It's basically called a single throw, double pull. And so what it does is, as a boater, you have the ability, you have three modes. You have off, and that would mean that your engine battery and its engine loads are disconnected. You'd have your house loads and your house battery disconnected. So all loads are disconnected from both your starter battery or your house battery. So that's the off state. On the on state, engine loads are connected to engine battery. House loads are connected to house batteries. So there's really four posts at the back of this battery switch, right? So connections to the batteries, connections to the loads. And that would be on. So that's why single throw, one turn of the switch, two things happen. Double pull. So you're basically energizing two things with only one action, which is good. And then some of you might say, well, yeah, but Jeff, great. So each battery is connected to its dedicated load. But what about emergency situations? And that's the third state of that battery switch is parallel. So that's where all batteries, engine and house, are also connected to starter loads and house loads. And so that battery switch is from Blue Seas. Off, on, combine is what it's commonly known. And that's exactly how you would run a boat where you can have one battery switch that allows you to have division of loads, which is important because when you were fishing, actually, by the way, and this happens more often than many of us care to remember, is that it's possible to have your engine running at low RPM and for you to be fishing out for a period of time, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 hours. Some people are out there longer than that. And to have, even though the engine is running, even though the alternator is outputting, the loads that are on your battery, i.e. the loads of the chart plotter, maybe the sound system, the fish finder, the VHF radio, maybe you have a fridge on, bait box, whatever it is, all those different things that are running at one time might, and this does happen, might exceed the output of your alternator. And so it does happen, unfortunately, for someone who's trolling at low RPM for extended period of time, to have the battery be completely drained and for you not to be able to start the engine because even though the engine was running, the loads to run exceeded what the amperage of the alternator could output at low RPM. So it's really useful in those situations to have a dedicated engine battery for the engine and a dedicated battery for the house. So that way, at least if one battery fails, you have the ability of combining them and putting them together to start the engine. So a great question out there. Thanks for asking and thinking about how to make your boat electrical system better. And thanks for all of you for watching as well. Safe boating out there. So if you're curious again, go on our website and find out more answers and solutions with this sort of setup. And thanks for asking. And thanks for all of you for listening and tuning in.